Everybody.
Hello.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the Film Buds podcast. This is episode number
81.
You got
it. Dope. It doesn't feel like it, but okay. I think I universe jumped. I came to terms with it.
Okay.
So now I know it's 81, but in my head, it's still like 89 or something.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. And my name is Henry.
I'm Chloe.
Chloe. And yeah, so this time around, we should just go ahead and say we are going to do an Avengers Endgame show, but sadly, our guests who are going to come on who are big comic book fans, that fell through for this weekend.
The ones you want to hear from.
Yeah, and so next weekend, hopefully, we'll at least get one of them, if not both of them, on for Endgames. And so
I'll be here.
Yeah, and so we decided.
I heard it leaked on the internet, so I'll watch it.
Nice.
It's probably got taken down by now, but.
Yeah. And so we will be doing that. We had a couple people comment, but yeah, so. Don't worry.
Don't fret.
Yeah, so, but this time around, we're
going
to
be back to our roots with an indie flick. Yeah, no one's going to watch.
Yeah, no one's, that's all, like only on Amazon. But
and you have to pay for it.
Well, yeah, it's a new movie.
It's not Amazon Prime.
No.
When you sent that to me, I was like, oh, dope, free movie.
Oh,
and then
no.
I said, excuse me?
Sorry.
Excuse me? I won't tell you how I watched it. Well, that'll be Schrodinger's cat.
Okay, all right. A little teaser.
Schrodinger's movie.
We're going to be talking about Under the Silver Lake, the new David Robert Mitchell.
Can I stop you?
Please.
I genuinely had a second of PTSD when you said under the, like my mind went to skin.
Under the skin? Check out that episode if you want.
I flipped the F out.
Yeah, not again. Don't worry.
Oh my God.
We're going to be talking about that, and we're going to be talking about another, I guess, noir, you can call it, which is
L.A.
Yeah.
Timeless, but, whatever.
Yeah.
Blah, blah,
Shane
blah.
Black's The
men.
Nice Guys.
Lots
men.
Of, lots of males.
Yeah, from
lots
2016.
Of ladies.
And, yeah, and then we have some, you know, some news, and we also got a listener question about our top five favorite albums of all time, switching it up a little bit.
We all have to make some, what is it called? You know, some little asterisks, like,
mm-hmm.
Not including soundtracks, not including blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
Because there's so much going on.
Yeah.
At least I will for mine. I will not. I would never limit you, Henry.
Oh, thank you.
Mm.
Yeah, I wanted to put the Dragon Tattoo. Is that my phone?
Boop-da-doop-doop.
Oh, sorry.
What is it, Henry?
It's that was the outro.
A little sneak peek.
That was the outro music. Sorry.
For the show?
Amy Winehouse, yeah. Because I was gonna mention I watched a new Amy Winehouse doc.
Oh, just, my God.
And then also it's part of my, well, let's not spoil it. Yeah.
I think we just did.
So well, Chloe, how you doing? Oh, and also one other thing. That we did a DC Cinematic Universe bonus show.
I wasn't invited.
Yeah. Where we talked about all seven DC films like Man of Steel, Batman v Superman, Aquaman.
I'm gonna list them all right now.
No, but we talk about all seven, and so that's on Bandcamp now for just $1.
If you can't fall asleep.
Yeah, and we had my buddy Paul on from who's in Texas.
My buddy Paul sounds like a Seth Rogen or Paul Ruddy, like a, I guess what I mean is a Judd Apatow kind of like
right
thingy. My Rudolph would have a cameo, like
yeah.
My buddy Paul.
I'd watch that, you know?
Yeah. That's basically what you need. Like, my, you know, I don't know. I can't remember stuff. I graduated. Like, what is that? I don't know. Buddy. I guess that's an adjective in this case.
I guess so.
Not really. Because I'm trying to do my idiot brother and my buddy Paul is like, you know, we all know what I mean. I'm going to stop now.
If anybody has suggestions for that, just let us know.
Make your own.
But yeah, so we talked about all seven films along with my friend Jacob Bowers, or Jacob Number One, as he's known on the show.
Doesn't have the same ring to it.
No, but so check that out. Even if you haven't seen any of them, or if you've seen all seven, just go ahead and give it a download.
I will.
Goes to support the show and all that. So, and we've already had some people download it, so thank you.
Thank you
so well
much.
As the Leonardo DiCaprio show.
Leo.
Which was great. And, but yeah, Chloe, how you doing?
Oh, dandily.
That's good.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
Told you, I did three jobs so far today.
Which were what?
I did the preschool. It was amazing.
Mm-hmm.
It's Masterpiece Week. So we taped. Look, schools are underfunded, y'all. So
That's for sure.
For Michelangelo, we taped a piece of paper under a table, and the kids had to paint or had to draw up, you know, for, like, Sistine Chapel.
Yeah.
Have you seen the Sistine Chapel? Very underwhelming
in person. Not in person, no. I have not.
Very underwhelming.
Hmm.
But what can you do?
Never meet your heroes,
Did I sound so snooty?
Right?
Like the croissant thing all over again? I've never had a croissant outside of France. You remember that?
Yeah. Never meet your heroes, right?
I don't like them anyway. Anti-Semite.
Oh, fair.
Anyway, and then they did a Monet thing. It was really, really, really cute. Oh, I just love them all. They're so adorable.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went to the clay, you know, I did some pugging.
Okay.
For those of you who know the lingo.
Yeah.
Those of you who don't.
What can you do?
Feel free to guess.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then I worked at the Penn Store. Wow.
Nice.
Crazy Aunt's Emporium.
Yeah.
Check it out,
y'all. A little local gym.
Greatest selection of pens in the country.
Yeah. From what I've seen. Yeah.
Yeah.
I've been to a lot of pen stores.
Less expensive than Amazon. We're actually one of only 7 brick and mortar left in the country.
Oh, yeah?
Less expensive than Amazon or Staples. Small businesses, y'all.
Hmm. Support it, right?
I was going to tell you something about politics that I was like, oh my God, but I can't remember now. So you're probably glad of that. So you're welcome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I'll mention I came really close to...
death.
Thankfully. Cross
Thank
my fingers.
God!
Slapping a very rude lady. Slapping a really rude rude lady
Not
at the
what
shop.
I thought that was... Good.
So
Henry,
yeah, I know.
You're the sweetest thing in the world.
It turns out I'm allergic to jerks.
but we get along so well.
Well, you're not a jerk, Chloe. But this,
thank you.
Yeah. But on Monday, I had been working kind of throughout the week before, and then kind of through Monday, and I was kind of tired just because
I'd
been working more than normal.
I'd
also been doing all these podcast stuff,
extracurricular activities.
Yeah, and as well as other things.
Yeah.
So I was kind of tired. I mean, not too tired, but ready to be done.
Not zombie land, but...
Yeah. And so in my last hour of my shift on Monday, this woman came in, maybe in her 30s, something like that. Just had a face that was like, I'm ready to...
Right, to get that one.
Yeah. And so she ordered 6 regular coffees.
Okay.
And she said, okay, well, could I have the 6th one in my own thermos mug? I said,
right.
Hey, I don't see a problem with that. Let's do it.
I would have said, why not the first one, imbecile?
Well, yeah, it's whatever.
Continue.
Glass half full, half empty type deal.
I'm definitely a half empty person.
Yeah. And we kind of said a few things back and forth after that, after I was prepping her coffee. And then she said, no, but you don't have to fill it up all the way in this thermos mug because that's, you know, what I'll just pay for. And a few more things were said back and forth. And somehow she got confused, and she said, probably in the most condescending way possible,
oh, no.
Okay, we're not communicating very well, are we?
Oh, my.
And just like kind of gave me, and so she then took the time to re-explain the entire order.
No.
With just me kind of sitting there like, you know.
Yeah.
Just rolling my eyes. And I was like, lady, you're.
Wait, so what was the miscommunication, as it were?
I have no idea.
We don't know.
I may have said something. I don't know.
Oh, dear
but
heavens.
It was, and then, yeah, she re-explained the whole.
It was a trying time.
Yeah, I was just like, lady.
Bring back Trenchcoat Man, am I right? He's better than this
lady. Oh, yeah.
Lady.
Yeah. yeah.
There's a little podcast, a scavenger hunt for you.
Yeah, go back to some of the earlier shows.
I'm not in that one.
To hear about.
So.
Oh, no? Oh, that's right. Yeah, Braden was on.
I was in Mexico.
Yeah. So I was like, lady, thanks for ruining my day.
Oh, my God.
But,
Henry, don't let anybody take your smile away, okay?
Oh, I was, when I left that place, I was smiling large.
Yeah.
But, she was the worst.
Sounds
to put it delicately, but you know,
she's a glass half full because I threw the other half in your face.
Yeah, but yeah, I came close. I was like, "Lady, you're pushing it.
Oof.
You're pushing my nice demeanor here."
Wow.
So, well, cool.
I can't think of a thing that's happened since I saw you because I can't remember crap.
It's okay. Don't worry.
But main assistant soccer game. Oh, I lost my mind on somebody. Oh, yeah. Shock.
Wow.
Shock. I mean, I lose my mind on somebody like every day. So I lost my mind on a kid today. She was pissing me off.
Well,
it's the same kid. She always pisses me off. I got to set her straight. You know
what
I mean?
You got that one kid. There's always that one kid.
There's not always that one, actually. No, yeah, there's usually one.
Usually. Okay.
Those are quite good odds, though. Like, most people, most children are perfection.
Uh-huh.
But this one, oh, my God.
A troublemaker.
Yeah, really? Yeah. Oh, my God. No, but this dude on my own soccer team slide tackled me during a game, and I lost my mind. I go crazy during soccer, though. Like, you want to watch something? You've seen Kicking and Screaming, my favorite movie?
Classic.
It is a classic, though. Mm. It's so good.
Yeah.
Up at times 10 is me and the... Because imagine me with all those endorphins, like, living my best life, like, trying to win. Oh, my God. Plus, my soccer team has been undefeated for 17 games. So, like, the pressure's really on.
Wow.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That was a humble brag there, I know. Wink, wink. But, like, oh, my God. The pressure's on. But I made an assist, so that was good. But also, that dude slide tackled me on my own team.
Jeez.
Oh, my God.
Once when I was young, I scored on my own team. I was like, why is no one chasing me?
That is so funny.
It was hilarious.
Oh, yeah. I almost lost. I accidentally got, you know, because mostly kids on my soccer, my kids' team can, like, deal with, like, they like my demeanor. Like, because, you know, I'm kind of funny to them
because
I'm way over the top, whatever. Like, I'm dealing. But there's this one boy. His name is Aurelio. And he is super sweet. And I was like, wrong way. Like, I was, and I always tell him, I'm like, I'm not yelling because I'm mad. I'm yelling so you can hear me and you're all doing great and I love you so much, right? But I'm still yelling. And this kid was taking the ball the wrong way. And I was like screaming, like, wrong way, right?
Yeah.
Reasonably. And then I really upset him and I apologized and it was all okay.
Well. We all, you know.
Oh, my God. I don't think I actually upset him that much. But but to me, I, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I never want to upset a kid. But I, too, have done that. And that's why I told him. I said, I've done that, Aurelio. And then I went into a deep spiral because I was like, please be okay. Please feel better. Like, be happy. You're a wonderful, perfect little child. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, one time, you scored on your own goal, right? Tell me if that's better than worse than not realizing you've gone, I was in third grade, gone from half field diagonally off your field into the wrong game.
Oh, you told me about that. Yeah, yeah.
Been like, why is I'm so effing fast?
I think that one, that might be worse.
And scored in a goal in another game. It's like in bowling when you go in the wrong lane, except worse.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Yeah, that was pretty bad.
That I haven't done.
Yeah. But. Also, I peed myself at practice when I was like, guess how old I was, though? Like, very publicly. It was clear I peed myself.
Like 13?
I think I was 15, yeah. Wow. Because I kid me. At least it's from I was laughing, right? But the boy I was, like, in love with was there, and it was a whole thing.
Mm.
Have I told this story?
Don't think so.
I don't know if I've reached those depths, but I told this story to Aurelio, basically. I was like, I've scored the wrong goal. I've peed myself. Like, it's fine. And the kids at that point, because I was trying to make them feel better, they're just like, you know, the crickets. They're like, wow, you're effed up.
Yeah.
But they like me. We get along great. My favorite kid, oh, no. I have a favorite kid. Is that bad? No, we all knew I would have a favorite kid. Like,
who doesn't have a favorite kid?
His name is Tobin. He's dope. You'd love him. Hmm. He's literally perf.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. And this kid I saw who's on my team. Am I talking too much? I just miss you.
No, it's like fine. Too much. Although I'm worried about this leaf blower guy outside.
I don't know if anyone else can even hear that.
I think.
Let us know. Email us at thefilmbloods@podcast.com.
Yeah, sorry, we're having this leaf blower guy. Sorry for the noise, if there was any. And sorry if he comes back.
So I've talked about Allie on this show. I don't know if this is I don't know if this is what we were talking about at this point.
No. But
we've talked about my friend Allie on the show.
Great.
Right?
Yep.
She's great, right?
Yeah.
Oh my God, she's literally the best.
Mm-hmm.
No offense.
No, it's fine.
Your numero dos in my eyes. Compared that's pretty to- good. Anyway, maybe this is the universe or like my guardian angel being like, Chloe, you've told the bedpan story. Why are you embarrassing yourself again? This is like the universe being like, stop. You don't know who's listening to this, you know? But
uh-oh, he's back.
Anyway, oh my gosh, I'm like Andrew Garfield in Under Silver Lake.
Oh,
like
yeah.
Everything has a oh boy, let's not get into that before we have to.
Yeah, right.
So anyway, oh, I hope you liked it so we can fight. Don't. Okay. Did you?
Oh yeah. I was like,
no. Oh my
gosh. Story.
All right. So anyways, my best friend Allie is the most amazing person. She's so, so sweet. There was a boy on our soccer team when I was 15 named Larry Lapushkin, and he was also very, very sweet. They basically are the two, I'm not being silly here, like the two sweetest people you could ever meet, right? Like, I'm surprised they didn't rip a hole in the universe with their sweetness being so close together. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So anyway, so Allie kicked the ball quite hard and hit Larry Lapushkin right in the face, right in the glasses, yeah. You know? Larry Lapushkin's exactly what you would imagine. Like, the wire glasses, Jufro, like, super pale, played elbow, like, the whole nine yards, nice. Right? And Allie is the kindest soul. So basically, Allie, of course, she hit poor sweet Larry Lapushkin in the face. She felt so bad, like, unimaginably bad, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so she was like, I'm so sorry, Larry. And then Larry, being the sweetest little thing in the whole world, felt so sad that Allie was sad that his response to make her feel... You don't understand. I've told this story so many times over the years. I can't
get it. She's losing it, everybody.
Oh, my God. It's the funniest thing ever because it's so sweet and so earnest. Okay, I'm going to try to get out. I can never get it out on the first
go. Take your time. Take your time.
Okay. So to make Allie feel better for feeling bad about hitting Larry Lapushkin in the face, Lapushkin responds, no, it's okay. I liked it.
Is this guy a masochist or something?
No, he was just trying to make her...
Well...
Yeah, and so I thought that was so funny. I peed myself.
Wow.
And it just was very public in front of the boy I liked and all that jazz, well, man.
Water under the bridge, right?
I'm sure there's a pun there that I don't want.
Yeah, probably.
But so I told Aurelio that to make him feel better, and I think it just made him think I was insane.
Mm.
But at least it distracted him from messing up big time.
Yeah. Wow.
Wow.
What a story. But, all right, well... should we get into the film?
Yeah.
All right. Well, yeah, with all that said, I guess...
I can't believe you like this stupid movie.
Oh, I can't... Oh, okay. Well, yeah, so let's get into our review of Under the Silver
Here's
Lake.
A clip, so let's take a listen.
So take
let's
a listen to a
in.
Clip.
Stay quiet.
What?
It means stay quiet. It's a hobo code.
Really?
Yeah. Hobos and rail riders used it a lot in the 1930s. Here. Take a look. They used it to let people know who was cool, who wasn't, what houses offer food, if there was a doctor in town that might be sympathetic to travelers, that sort of thing.
Okay, so why is it in Sarah's room? And who were they telling to be quiet?
I don't know. Maybe you. There's been this rash of lost and found signs for dogs, humans, musical instruments over the past 2 years. Something really big is going on. I know it.
And you think any of this could be connected to Sarah?
Of course. I mean, it could be a lot of things. Sex and drug trafficking, the cult of the whale, the dog killer, I don't know. Lately, I just assumed that the owl's kiss has something to do with everything.
Not so sure about that.
Okay, so Under the Silver Lake is written and directed by David Robert Mitchell, stars Andrew Garfield, Riley Coe, Wendy Vanden Heuvel, Deborah Geffner.
Oh, so many stupid cameos. I can't deal with stupid cameos. They're so distracting.
Right.
Zosia Mamet from Girls was in it. Freaking Topher Grace was in it. All these random people. That's
oh yeah Topher
squirrel.
Grace. So
what the heck?
So the synopsis is: Sam, intelligent but without purpose, been there, right?
He also didn't seem intelligent.
Finds a mysterious woman swimming in his apartment's pool one night.
She wasn't mysterious. She was literally just swimming in a pool, and he didn't find her. He was literally stalking her.
That's true.
Yeah.
And the next morning, she disappears. Sam sets off across LA to find her, and along the way, he uncovers a conspiracy far more bizarre. So, yeah, this one...
Are we doing spoilers?
Well, I guess we should say, since there are a lot of little weird twists and stuff, we will do like a spoiler discussion that we'll put at the end of the show. All right.
Oh, not so
right
this
now,
mind.
Right now,
mess
right
again.
Now, spoiler free. But this one is an A24 film and also had some pretty big release distribution
failure
issues. I think it premiered at Cannes last year.
To lukewarm.
But then it got pushed back once
three
and
months.
Then I think twice and then.
Or three times.
Yeah, a couple times. And so. Finally, it's just been released on Amazon.
Probably because it sucks.
On Amazon. And then also maybe a limited release in theaters. I don't know.
I think there was, yeah.
Okay.
Probably just like LA and what have you.
Yeah. So this one is done by the guy who directed It Follows, which was a huge hit when it came out.
It's really a Donnie Darko, Southland Tale situation.
Mm. Well, Chloe,
what'd I think of it?
What'd you think of this one? Now, you were... In a way, I guess
I was so excited.
You're looking forward to it.
I was super excited, but don't get it twisted now. It wasn't that my expectations were set super high because it was delayed so much. It like went out of my mind. You know what I mean? And
yeah.
I was like, oh, you know? Also, I don't love Andrew Garfield.
Right.
I don't hate him.
No.
I can't. He's Meshbucha. Mm. Just kidding. I hate Bernie Madoff. Don't get with it. What's his name? Bernie Madoff.
I can't even think of his name.
The jerk.
Yeah.
Anyway, you see my point.
Huh.
But what's his name? Bernie Madoff. We got there.
Madoff.
Robert De Niro.
Yeah.
I love Michelle Pfeiffer. Okay. So anyway. But I don't love it. So I was like very excited because I was like, oh my gosh, something new and original and cool, whatever. And then the first thing, I found out Silver Lake is a real lake. And I said, oh, I'm much less interested now.
Why?
It's just who I am.
Okay.
They had invented a whole new thing, like new.
This is an original script. It's pretty impressive.
I hear you. Guess what? He wrote it when he was sweaty in his room when he was 13 and he hasn't gotten over it. We've talked about this before. This is classic. Put it right in the category of pubescent boy who grew up, who got some money and made the movie he wanted to make about being.
Sure.
Come on.
All right.
It's a real Ernest Cline of a movie, okay?
Oh, yeah.
That's the dude who did Ready Player One. And Steven Spielberg really improved it. So don't judge what I'm saying by the movie. It's all on Ernie. The book is, I'm trying to not be like vulgar and explaining.
It's
how
okay.
I can't. My mouth won't let me. You know how I am.
Well, I think we talked about that on the Ready Player One show anyways.
No, I just have a lot of, you know, I like to speak in a...
Metaphor
and analogy and stuff, right? So I have a lot of words that I want to say, but I shan't. You can get the idea.
All right.
Like, just like... it's just such like a
but
get some proactive and sit down,
right?
I hate movies like this. They're like sorry Henry, they're really chauvinistic and also
magical realism. No?
That's the other thing. They're pissing on what I love most with their self-indulgent, self-involved mishigas. It's not good. The plot was stupid. I know you're not a plot person.
No.
But it has no bones. Plot for me should be bones to excellent character and what have you, okay? No bones means a floppy body, okay?
Vivid image.
It can't go anywhere. Like, it's just no bueno. And also, Andrew Garfield, like, and I don't mean, what's his name? Sam?
Yeah.
I don't mean Andrew Garfield. You see how I got uncomfortable saying that name and I said it, and with like a weird accent.
Mm.
Anyway, so like but yeah, just like his character was not, I mean, I'm not saying he's supposed to be super likable, right?
Mm.
But like I was also just bored out of my effing mind watching him, and also like I hate him. He's like the type of person I hate.
Okay. You didn't like the when he stuffs the egg in the kid's mouth?
Okay, I did like that.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Honestly, I would just call the police, obviously. Because I'm a logical human who wants actual, you know, tangible retribution instead of punching a 10-year-old.
Not frontier justice, right?
Which, amounts to nothing. Like, there's no satisfaction in that for me, but also I think he, he enjoys, without spoiling anything, enjoys a bit of aggression.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, no. Unrelated, just not aggressive. And I don't need it. You know me. I don't need a character to be relatable to, like, a movie, you know? Mm-hmm. But just, oh, my God, roll my ass. Also, Riley Coe can sit down. I'm so over
she's
her.
She's been in, like, she's.
She always plays the same person.
It's like this kind of mysterious person who ends up, I don't know what their best word is.
I really don't like her.
I mean, I like her. It's just that I think she's, maybe it's she's being typecast. I don't know. But
no,
like,
I don't know, because she got into it through nepotism, so she could have done whatever she wants. I don't respect her career choices, so I don't respect her.
I like her in American Honey, and I like her in Logan Lucky. Those are the two that I think she's quite good in.
Yeah, but even those go together. Like, she does the same crap over and over again. I just can't put some pants on for a role. Jesus Christ.
That's fair.
That's not a judgment. And I don't mean that. I don't mean that in a judgment of what she looks like in any way, what the role she chose to play exactly, right?
Mm-hmm.
What I mean to say is, to put it a little more understandably, she always plays the exact same person, and I've never seen her wear a pair of pants. But you all know what I mean. I don't mean that she shouldn't, you know what I mean.
That's fair.
If you want to go pantless, you go pantless. But sometimes wear pants just to make things, you know, mix it up a little bit.
Sometimes wear pants,
you
right?
Know? You know? Now, I will say, the original casting was Dakota Johnson. I think that would have been way better. I think Dakota Johnson could have slid into this movie so well.
That would have been good, yeah.
Yeah. But no, I just think this was a self-indulgent piece of crud.
Hmm.
I think it's one of those, like, I think it was because, you know, he's coming off of a big success.
Right.
Which is why I compared it to Donnie Darko. Like, big success, then made this thing. And the same with Southland Tales. It was like his passion project, whatever. These men who make their passion projects need to bring their scripts to therapy, dive into it, say, oh, this is really bad.
Mm-hmm. What about Scorsese and Silence?
You can shut your effing mouth. What do you mean?
That was his passion project.
That's different. He's lived a whole career, first of all. Okay. I'm glad you brought up Scorsese, because I was watching it, and I was like, Scorsese knows how to embrace those who came before him in his field so well.
Mm-hmm.
And this movie did the opposite. Like, the stupid camera work with the zoom it, because, you know, it's supposed to be kind of 70s vibe, whatever, with the zooms and stuff.
Yeah.
God awful, over the top, the crossfades, which are supposed to be from, like, you know, like the 50s, or the crossfade thing is very 50s. It just did not work. Like, and I didn't get enough of that, like, I already used the word sweat because I was talking about, like, teenage boys, but I mean in a different vibe, like that sweaty kind of, I need this movie to have, like, that hot, sticky summer feel. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, you got to check out Inherent Vice then.
Yeah, I know. This I put in the same category of failure as I do Hot Summer Nights.
I've forgotten all about that movie. Yeah.
To me, it's the exact same thing. And it's like the attempted nods to the filmmakers you love with all the unsubtle, you know, little like winks, like Rear Window and crap. You ain't no Hitchcock. And then they had Hitchcock. I say, he does not want to be associated with this movie.
Mm.
Oh my God.
You know what made this movie? The Johnny Depp face mask.
The effing Spider-Man BS. That pissed me. That's when I was done.
When was that?
Oh, credits. I'm out of here. Oh, I'm done.
Hmm.
Andrew Garfield sits up. He's got a comic book of The Amazing Spider-Man.
Oh, I missed that.
I don't know if y'all are aware, but Andrew Garfield played Spider-Man, okay?
Yeah.
It's meta BS.
Hmm.
And then there's this thing about gum, and he had the gum on his hand, right? And so he went to pick up the magazine. It stuck to his hand like it does in Spider-Man when he wakes up and realizes he's Spider-Man.
Okay.
And I said,
yeah, I didn't. I missed the comic book.
I said, either way, this is bad. Either this is intentional, which is some meta BS where you know he's Andrew Garfield, and I hate that, number one. Second option is, with this intricate web you're trying to weave where everything is supposed to mean something, if you missed that somehow, then that's a failure as well. Basically, it's a lose-lose for me. I'm sorry you're not going through to the next round. I hated it.
Wow. See, I thought you would like it. But I guess I can't read people.
So that's the thing. It's like, no, Henry, don't say that. It's like the same kind of deal as I should like Hot Summer Nights.
Mm.
But it's so hollow, empty, no heart. These men think they have, and I'm not, they both have to be dudes. These guys think that they like,
they're king of the world.
Yeah. And you ain't, you're not, you're not.
Right.
You're not. And I like that it's the original story, but it could have, it needed a lot of tinkering. Like the whole graphic novel angle could have been way cooler. It should have taken, they needed to pick a lane. And also Andrew Garfield was an a-hole, but not in a fun way.
Okay.
Maybe some recasting. Jude Law would have been dope. Jude Law opposite Dakota Johnson would have really improved this movie, but not, it wouldn't have saved it because it's horrible. And the freaking homeless king, I can't deal with.
Oh, yeah. Love that guy.
I can't deal with this random stuff. Like, it has the making, and that's the thing, though. It's got the makings because they've watched the Masters. But you're basic. Hmm. You think you ain't, but you're basic.
Wow. Harsh. Laying down the law.
Wow.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Well,
Not to mention, did I say this was misogynistic yet? Freaking manic pixie, oh my God, and it thinks it's self-aware, and it's like, oh my God.
There's a lot of boobs in it. A lot of nudity.
A lot, but not Andrew.
No, you see him naked.
No, you don't.
Yeah, you do.
You see his little tushy.
Oh, there you go.
No.
Well, I mean, that's, if you go full frontal, that's, you know, pushing the, that's no. Shame territory there.
Oh,
that's NC-17.
God. Oh, my God. Come know? On. Come on.
But
No, but, ugh.
All right. Well, I mean, I'll kick my review off here. So I was pretty skeptical going into this by the trailers and by even just by, like, the news.
The trailers were dope. I feel like they knew they missed the mark when they made the trailers. Like, the movie was going to miss the mark by the trailer being so dope. Like, they gave it a completely different tone.
Hmm. Yeah, maybe. I mean, I thought that I was worried at first because it looked like a wannabe Inherent Vice, which is one of my favorite films. And I had forgotten completely about Hot Summer Nights, so that wasn't really in my mind. But I was a little skeptical going in, and it started off a little... unfocused, which it is unfocused overall, and I can completely see why it's divisive, like why you hate it and others don't. I'll say I actually really, really liked it. Not as much as something like Inherent Vice or even like The Nice Guys that we'll get to, but I thought for one, I mean, you're commenting on the direction. I thought the direction was fantastic.
The Mulholland Drive me off a cliff. David Lynch well said. Would have vomited if he watched this movie.
Yeah.
Mark my words, he would have said, oh, they stole my ideas except made them crap.
Well, great. See, I thought the direction, I thought it looked amazing, and I thought that how things were shot and even just the locations were very unique, and I just loved how it was edited and shot. And I agree there are callbacks to other films, but for whatever reason,
and directors, which is way worse.
Yeah, that wasn't really in my mind for whatever reason. I don't know. But I thought it was just a weird kind of very unlike anything else that's come out this year for me. And that was refreshing, at least. But I just enjoyed some of the weird encounters that he has. I liked, I guess, some of the commentary towards the end about what the whole kind of journey is about. I like that. And we can get to that in spoilers, but I really like the score by Disaster Piece, although it's maybe a little too similar to Johnny Greenwood with Inherent Vice, but still really enjoyed it. I like the fake rock band, Jesus and the Brides of Dracula. Pretty solid. Pretty solid
name.
It didn't
make any... Okay, yeah.
No.
Again, there are a lot of plot holes.
Yeah. And I agree that it is lacking a lot of subtext throughout the middle, but for the most part, I was completely in. I was just curious as to what was going to be happening next or what you were going to see.
That's
see
how
next.
You get into bad relationships, Henry.
Tell me about it, you know. But, no.
Need a stable movie with a happy ending.
Hey, you know, nothing wrong with that. But this time around, I just, you know, it would go from like a, you know, a bomb shelter to a, I don't know, the lake. And I mean, it was just like in terms of the visuals and how it was shot in particular, I loved, and I felt like it really put a unique spin on on that type of film, although obviously it does call back to other things. And I mean, for the most part, I enjoyed Andrew Garfield. I kind of liked how his character was a little unhinged. Like, you know, stuffs the egg in the kid's mouth. Like, that's unexpected, but it was good. I agree that the way that the movie starts off with why he goes on this journey is a little weak. But
how do you think the movie dealt with females, Henry?
How the movie dealt with females? I mean,
speaking of how the story started off.
Oh, when he's having sex with the girl?
Oh, that was pretty good. I meant later.
When he was there watching the news.
So weird.
It was weird, but it was, you know.
Also, the whole Playboy thing, super weird. Like, she should have thought that was weird. But, I mean, maybe she has issues, too. Also, that lady is... See, I don't like all these, like, subtly famous people popping up in a movie like this.
Yeah, but in terms of that, I agree that it was, at times, maybe a little too...
Chauvinistic.
Yeah, but I enjoyed, in terms of the direction, I liked how comfortable it felt, just with how it shot things. Even just in terms of the nudity, I thought that, like, it portrayed things... realistically, and it felt kind of natural, like you were actually there in the room rather than it just...
Let me get something straight fast. Nudity does not bother me.
No.
We discussed my upbringing. That might sound quite odd out of context. I grew up, you know, naked people. No, it's still weird out of context.
Yeah, just keep
there
going.
There are a lot of life drawing in my house, classes in my house. Saw a lot of naked people by accident. I thought it was Narnia behind the curtain, and it won't.
But
the way they deal with, I'm talking more about the actual relationships and
I agree.
Characters.
Sure.
You think, oh boy, yeah.
No, but in terms of not the relationships necessarily, but just how it was shot, again, it felt kind of like it was self-aware and comfortable with being kind of more... I don't know if adult is the right word, but just being a little more raw.
That's not what I'm asking you about.
I know that, but I'm simply saying a few thoughts before, you know, we get into the heart of this thing. But I agree, at times it did feel a little like pretty much all the women in it were kind of, you know, sex crazed, you know, kind of women, which, you know.
Very flat characters.
Yeah, I mean, there's not a lot to most people in it. And so that I will completely agree with. But for the most part, it was just so abstract and weird that I enjoyed going on the journey for the most part. But I agree, it did at times dip a little too much into self-indulgence. But I still liked the commentary about there's always kind of another person behind the art and or behind certain things that you might think are amazing that one person did. There's always other people around them who are a part of that. And what? What?
You're really, yeah.
What?
I mean.
I mean, there's nothing deep in it by any means, but I just enjoyed the, it's like it's lacking the resonance of something like Inherent Vice, and it's also lacking the comedy of, or the high comedy of
The
Nice Guys, right? Which at first I was worried about, but I felt like it dipped into enough weird, situations and sequences that I was...
It distracted you from how bad it is.
Sure. Sure. But I immediately just wanted to rewatch it right when it finished. And I was worried about the runtime. It was, you know, it's two hours and 20 minutes. But after a while, it could have been a half hour longer and I would have enjoyed it, honestly. But I just enjoyed his journey. I enjoyed the weird encounters. I liked... it just felt, it was refreshing and...
What? It's the least refreshing movie of all.
To me, it was
like if you turned on your faucet and you got some brown water and you said,
uh-oh.
That's refreshing.
Let me say this. It was refreshing in comparison to what has come out this year.
That's still not good. That's not, I don't think things
should
be.
With the state of cinema these days.
No, Henry, that's such weak sauce.
But it's been a while since I've seen a movie that kind of felt like it really was ambitious. And at times, indulgence isn't always good or beneficial to a film, but I felt like in this, at least in some cases, it was, and I appreciated it for throwing in weird characters and weird visuals and extending some sequences longer than maybe they should be. But it was just interesting to me to watch, even though in retrospect, it wasn't as thoughtful as it could have been, or as I may like it to be, but still, I know, but still, still enjoyed the journey, like the performances. The score, cinematography, I was in.
Wow.
I mean, of course, something like Inherent Vice is much better. And then I feel like there's one more similar to it, but
a lot kind of similar to it.
Well, I feel like
LA Confidential.
Yeah. Well, I feel like Inherent Vice is kind of rejuvenated the neo-noir, the drug-hazed.
Naven, Simon, and Shimon.
What?
The movie called Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
And what's that one with Johnny Depp?
That one. Oh, The Rum Diary? I do love
No, there's another one I'm thinking of.
Oh, it's Fear and Loathing.
No, there's another one I'm thinking of.
Another one.
Basically, I mean...
Mordecai? But, and so I guess
my uncle's name.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
But yeah, so I guess I'm just like a sucker for these movies, with the exception of Hot Summer Nights.
I'd much rather watch Hot Summer Nights. No, that's probably not true. Well, maybe.
But and who knows? Maybe I was just in the right mood, in the right place. But I enjoyed it quite a bit, much more than I thought I would. I was worried going in, like I said. But and I like
Romney effect.
I like the moments of horror that kind of made it feel like
the squirrel.
The squirrel. The
I really didn't like the squirrel. Also, I'm not trying to be like this.
No, please.
But it genuinely actually bothered me, the dream sequence when her face is different.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
That actually really bothered me.
Yeah.
Not like I don't like how you chose to do that.
Interesting.
I think that's messed up.
Yeah.
It just was very offensive in a few ways.
I can see that.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Can we get over that stereotype that people with big noses are scary and mean? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Speaking as a medium-sized nose person, I think.
You have a good nose, Chloe.
Thank you, Henry.
You're welcome.
But you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I just really hate that.
Mm-hmm. I liked the look of his apartment as well. I thought, and that whole location, that felt very It Follows-y, you know?
Mm.
But yeah, I just liked the choice of locations. I thought they... made thing that well,
let's
made
get it, the location scout a raise.
Yeah, give him or her a raise, because they did a good job. But I just liked its abstract nature, you know.
I'd rather watch Mulholland Drive.
I would too. I would too.
LA Confidential. I'd rather watch
even Inherent with Kevin Vice. Spacey in there.
No, I didn't mean that. I didn't mean LA Confidential. Okay. Honestly, I meant Fear and Loathing.
Really?
Mm. Yeah.
I feel like when people say nowadays that they like Fear and Loathing, I feel like they haven't watched
it. You think they're posers?
No, I feel like they...
Is it bad?
It's not great now, but I feel like people who say that haven't watched it since it came out.
That is just... I wasn't alive when it came out. Was I? I definitely did not watch it.
It was maybe 97, 98?
Yeah, I was two. So I probably... Actually,
You didn't check that one out at the theater?
I probably did, honestly.
Yeah.
With a good old...
Or at least they haven't watched it in a decade. And
I probably have not seen it in a decade.
Yeah. It feels... Even though I love Johnny Depp, having rewatched it in the last couple of years, it feels very dated.
Well, let me tell you something,
Henry. The Rum Diary is much better.
Let me tell you something, though, Henry.
What's that?
The bar for what I would rather watch than this is quite a last round of limbo.
That's fair.
You're catching my feel.
Yeah, I catch it.
All so right. I could say a lot of movies I'd rather watch than this.
Oh, sure. But yeah, I loved the sequence in the lake where, you know, they're in the water. I guess it's on the poster, I guess. But I love that. And again, there are plenty of things that I wouldn't be able to explain, but... At times I liked that. Other times I didn't.
I just don't like all the, I don't like all the nods, like the How to Marry a Millionaire thing where it ties in.
I didn't mind that.
Directly with the plot and like, why'd you leave that box, that shoebox and stuff? And
yeah.
Why is Zosia Mammoth in this movie?
Yeah.
There's like a long list of stuff.
Yeah.
And he might be the least likable person of all time, but not in a good way.
I didn't have really an issue with those things. Usually I do, but I didn't in this for whatever reason. Maybe, who knows, maybe it was just a weird day for me.
Henry, you embrace what you care about. Not putting you down. Oops.
Thank you.
Nor your what makes you happy.
Thank you.
You know?
You too, Chloe. I would never...
I mean, I wouldn't notice.
Yeah, so, I mean, it's... again, I get why it's divisive, and I wouldn't judge anyone for saying they hated it like you did, or for saying they absolutely loved it.
I would.
I can see how, similar to Inherent Vice, I think, I can see how someone could watch this, and it's like their new all-time favorite movie. I could just see, this is that type of movie.
Me too, and guess what? If any of the boys who think that, I won't go out with you.
Yeah. Laying down the law, right?
Honestly.
Yeah, there you go.
Because I've learned, it would not.
Yeah.
Well, I guess, but you're a catch, Henry.
Oh, thank you.
But, you I mean, know, it's not your favorite movie.
It's not my favorite movie.
Exactly. If this is, honest to God, is someone's favorite movie, that's like, I literally can't.
I can see that happening.
Because it's creepy. Like, not, the movie's like kind of creepy on purpose, right? But if this is your favorite movie, I find that extremely creepy, unsettling, that this is like your heart song. Like, I cannot with you, so I'm not going to.
Yeah. But, and I like
to. And you won't want to with me because I'm a woman who actually has words come out of her mouth.
Yeah.
And I think I should get paid the same. And if this is your favorite movie, you probably don't care.
Oh.
You probably think that's a conspiracy. Like, a lot of people, did you say that a lot of Americans think that women get paid and they're like told no, and they're like, no, it's fine.
Oh, yeah. Oh, one thing about this director, which is just weird, is it's the same thing and It Follows. He has characters like our age watching movies that we almost no one would be watching at our age. So in It Follows, when Micah Monroe and the dude are in their house, they're watching like Frankenstein, and in this he's watching like a silent film.
Yeah,
like 99% of people, unless you're
us
would not actually be watching that. Like, pick, have them watch The Office, right? the most watched show on Netflix right now.
Yeah, that restored my faith in humanity, like, honestly.
Like, I do not see Andrew Garfield watching a 1920s
There's
film.
No way that bro would be watching that movie.
No. Nor do I see it in It Follows.
He'd be watching effing Sharknado.
Micah Monroe would not watch Frankenstein.
There's no way.
Know? No. So, fix that, David.
Fix it!
Fix it.
That's why I'm talking about the self-indulgent, blah, blah, blah.
I agree. It's self-indulgent. But in this case, for whatever reason, I didn't mind it for the most part. There's one scene in particular. There's this party scene towards the beginning. I felt like that felt really extended. And that was at a point where I was like, okay, am I going to like this or not? But then...
I low-key don't even remember.
Yeah. But then it just coasted along, and I was loving it for whatever reason. I don't know. Well, I ain't sorry.
You liked the way it was. That was a Beyonce reference. Well, you liked the way it was filmed, and I didn't. And if you like the way something's filmed, then that's really going to keep you going as well.
I could say I loved how it was filmed. I can say that. I was like, I was just waiting for the cool shots to.
You know what I thought?
Appear in front of me. What's that?
Basic.
Yeah. Hey. No judgment there. So.
Cinematography can sip its pumpkin spice latte all day.
Preach it, man. Preach it. But yeah, I was very pleasantly surprised.
Preacher's a good show.
I've seen the pilot. I like all
of Preacher in one sitting before I'd watch this movie again.
Oh, yeah.
As long as I can have my stationary bike.
it is a good show from what I've seen. And it has Ruth Wilson. Ruth Negga.
Ruth Negga.
Of Loving fame.
Who's Ruth Wilson again? Oh, that lady. I don't like her.
Lone Ranger.
She's
in that new.
She's the other. She's the version of that I don't like of Michelle Monaghan. See, I have them for everybody.
Yeah, she's on a new show on.
I'm the version of Natalie Portman I don't like.
Mystery.
Which one?
It's something about where this husband cheats or has like multiple families, and she's the wife of
again. She was in The Affair. Yeah, doing that again?
This is different.
These people need to keep it moving. That's like Jessica Chastain, you're not allowed to be an astronaut again. Like, you know what I mean?
Oh, right. Yeah, she was in The Martian.
Come on. She's in 7 astronaut movies in a day.
Wow. Yeah. But, yeah, well, actually, I guess I don't really have anything spoiler to talk about. Do you?
I mean, it's really not worth it to me, honestly.
Yeah, I thought I did, but I
mean, it's just stupid. Like, I basically, if we did a spoiler review, I would just, like, pick at all the holes in it.
Mm.
And also, like, we all know who the dog murderer is.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on.
So
I'm with the homeless gang on that one. You know?
Yeah. Yeah, I liked the James Dean. That was good.
Oh my god! Roll my effing eyes.
It's obvious, but I felt like it was kind of tongue in cheek, and so I didn't mind it. I felt like it was self aware.
No, disagree. Well, you're too kind.
Maybe. Maybe so. I wasn't. I didn't want to give David Robert Mitchell a. You know.
He's no coffee shop lady. You didn't want to slap him in the face.
No. Yeah. Not this time, but so you like It Follows? You're a
yeah, it's fine.
Yeah,
I'm a follower. So you're trying to think of like a
oh, that's pretty
good.
I
know you like to do those.
I wasn't thinking of that. But yeah, that's good.
Oh my gosh, I can say I'm an It girl if I like It.
Oh yeah, there you go. But yeah, Chloe, is this the mother of this year? You know,
I'm
loving it. You're hating it.
Yeah, could be.
There's got to be one every year, I think.
Yeah, this could be. Please don't comment again, that dude. Oh, yeah. Oh Jesus.
Well,
probably
think,
you can only do it once, right?
Do what? You can only
we
comment
have a
once.
Troll. Chloe has a troll.
Well, it's just the one star.
It was. It really hit me hard, man,
really?
When it happened initially. Well, it was also when we had just, or you had done it. I had just started this.
Yeah.
I never did anything like this.
You were
this.
Just a few episodes in.
Oh, my
in.
Gosh.
Ready for the wolves.
Oh, and then
right?
I was a...
I know. Shame on you, whoever you are. Shame on you. You know?
Aww.
But luckily for that, we've had 5 stars ever since, I think.
Yeah, I think so.
From what I can see.
Group polarization, am I right?
Yeah. You know?
This could be the mother, yeah.
Might be.
Was the mother and Ghost Story different years? Yeah. Shoot.
No, Ghost Story and Mother were the same year.
Same year?
Last
wow, that
year.
That was a rough one.
Well, you haven't seen Suspiria, but that, you probably
we
feel,
all know that'd be it.
You'd probably feel
yeah,
that way.
We all
yeah.
know that'd be it.
So.
At least cool. We both love La Danse.
La Danse. What a brilliant film. Been meaning to rewatch that, yeah. Well, because I'm going to that ballet in May with
what
my
ballet?
Friend. Oh, I guess I talked about it on the show that you weren't there. But yeah, so in mid-May,
my story of my life.
I'm going with my friend Ashley from Joe Van Gogh to see
nice.
A production of Swan Lake at the Raleigh or at the Carolina
Ballet
Company.
Oh, nice. I yeah. love, I used to, yeah, I used to go to those all the time
yeah,
with my
so
grandparents.
We're going to that in a couple
That'll
weeks.
That'll be so much fun.
So I'll have
Swan
to watch.
Swan Lake scares the F out of me. Keep an eye out for some funky stuff. We know how it can be,
yeah.
Aronofsky.
Yeah.
Aronofsky,
yeah. You got it.
Darren, that's Italian, isn't it?
Mm.
Wow.
Yeah, so I'll have to rewatch La Danse beforehand.
La Danse and Black Swan.
Well, I just did for our review of
it. You gotta
it
do it again.
Few weeks. Yeah, I'll have to rewatch it. Fair
oh,
enough.
Oh, tell me about the garden thing. I'm dying to know.
Oh, yeah, so my mother...
Henry just got spooked at a noise he himself made, by the way.
Oh, did I? Oh, was that me?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like my cat likes to chase his tail.
Classic.
Yeah.
Yeah, so my mother is going to be... Sorry to veer off here, but my...
I'm dying to know about it.
Yeah,
it's in all the British... Because I've never actually heard of this really happening, but in all the British, you know, sweet murder shows I watch, you know? Because I only watch cute murder shows.
Mm.
Like mystery shows. You know what I mean? Like
yeah.
Agatha Raisin. There's always one of these events,
oh,
and somebody always dies.
Prediction here. Murder.
No.
I hope
God
not.
Forbid.
But yeah, so my mother, I mean, if you don't know, which is like everybody listening. So my mother has a pretty big garden. She's
it's so beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, so she has
I'm she's honored
a,
to have
she's
seen
a
it.
Master gardener. She might even have that title officially. I don't know. But this year there's a local tour, like garden tour, that where some of the big
gardens.
I don't know if they're chosen or people volunteer and then they're chosen. I don't know.
I would assume.
Yeah, but
no, people just roll up.
Yeah, but either way, my mother's garden is going to be on the tour again this year. She's been on it a few times before, but it's where the local, you know, rich whites get up from their recliners and yeah. Go to all these Stroll. Various.
That is so weird. Do you put out like hors d'oeuvres in the British shows? So. They put out hors d'oeuvres because they want to win.
I don't think we're doing that. Maybe we'll have water because it's the summer.
Lemonade.
You know?
At least up it to lemonade, you know?
Yeah, something like that. But yeah, so we're going to have people, you know, touring my mother's garden.
Do they rate it? Is it competition?
I don't know. I don't think so. I
think no murder, probably.
Yeah. But apparently, it is kind of like, even if there is no competition, apparently it is a little cutthroaty.
Yeah.
To pun intended.
Yeah.
So, you know, people sabotaging. I mean, no.
Yes.
Although I could see that happening with some people.
I bet it does.
Yeah.
Our neighbors have done that to us. We don't get along with them. It's very sad.
Wow. But yeah, so it's going to be this Saturday. Wow. And I've been helping her out a lot, move
so
things.
Or exciting.
It's like, hey, Henry, can you help me move everything in my garden around?
Yeah.
That's
some feng shui.
That's been my life for the last couple of weeks. Wow. Or my whole life, rather.
That's yeah.
What you see outside, that's all because of me.
Henry, no. I'm trying to build myself a deck so I know where you're at. It's an undertaking. I should have known given the sentence. I was trying to build myself a deck, but we'll make it happen.
Yeah.
It's happening. You wait and see. By my Game of Thrones party, we'll have a beautiful little deck out there.
Okay. Cool. I'm in.
Can't wait.
If
anyone's interested, you're welcome to my Game of Thrones party.
It's nice of you.
Mm-hmm.
But, yes.
You'll have to find it. You'll have to Andrew Garfield it.
Yeah. Well, okay, well, out of 5 stars? Don't worry, I'm not going 5.
Okay, wait. This is like a little upsetting. What came to me to give this as a rating?
Say it.
Okay. I'm sorry if this makes you uncomfortable.
Never.
What came to mind when you asked me for the rating was a memory.
Oh,
actually.
God. Uh-oh.
This boy. Should I say his name? No, I shan't.
Do I know him?
No.
Then say it.
I won't.
Okay.
I won't.
A boy.
I was walking in the halls.
A young man.
A boy. And no, boys are sweet. A male.
Okay.
A male. Walking in the halls in 7th grade. And from behind me, he like snapped my, like he pulled my bra strap. You know?
What?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah. So that's what I give this movie.
Me
the
too.
The feeling
movement.
Of that. Yeah.
The start of that.
It's just like. That's what this reminds me of.
That's weird.
Yeah.
I'm sorry that happened.
I feel slightly assaulted by
it was
this movie.
Probably the mother reviewer, right? Probably him.
No, that's the problem. I think it's a sign of affection.
Yeah.
That's the issue.
Yeah.
You see?
Men, right?
That's what I give this movie.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I'll...
sorry, Henry.
I'll go.
I had to be real with you
no.
about what came to mind.
I'll go 4.5 here. It could go down to a 4. I don't know.
Okay.
Could this be an opposite King Arthur situation? It goes down to a 1.5 in a week. I don't
know.
Yeah,
that'd be so funny.
We'll see.
We'll see.
You know, speaking of weird young things,
Charlie
when Henry. I was in elementary school, a kid just randomly elbowed me in the stomach. I was walking behind him. Maybe he was angry that I was right behind him. I don't know. I wasn't creeping on him. I was just going over to.
Oh, my God. Wait, I bet you were so cute.
Maybe.
I don't know what you looked like when you were little. I can't picture
I'll find
it.
A picture at some
I
point.
I looked just like, have I told you this?
You looked the same?
I acted the same.
Mm.
I looked just like the, what's her name? A kid told me I did the, I looked identical to the American girl, Samantha. The doll.
Okay.
Yeah. And the kid used to call me Samantha in elementary school. So I don't know if that's a compliment or an insult, but I certainly took it as an insult.
I don't know.
I had these big old front teeth. Well, look her up and then decide.
Mm. But yeah, I was just trying to get to the swings on the playground, and this kid just went like and elbowed me. Dang. took the breath right out of me.
That sucks.
I don't know. To this day, I don't know why he did it.
Wow.
But you know, we're.
I had an assistant.
We're not friends. So.
An assistant teacher who wouldn't let me go on the swings because I was a Jew.
Jesus.
Yeah, she literally said.
What's the connection there?
What do you mean? Because she wanted me to be happy.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay. Weird.
Yeah, super weird.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. Super weird. I mean, I obviously went on the swings anyway.
Discrimination at its
worst. I literally said, what are you going to do? Because what was she going to do? The worst you can do is put me in timeout. Fine. Then I'll go to the principal and tell her you're a racist.
Yeah.
Because she was also a racist. She also, to be fair, she also wouldn't let the black kids on the swings.
Hey, so. Yikes.
Yeah.
Shame on you.
Oh, mate. Yeah. It was terrible.
Jeez.
I know.
All right. Well.
I also got decked randomly in elementary school.
I think maybe everybody does at some point.
Get decked in the randomly?
Yeah. All right. Well, I guess we can move on.
Really didn't see it coming.
Hey, you never do, right? I didn't see this kid. Brandon. Brandon was his name.
Oh, Brandon.
Yeah. Thanks for elbowing me Spencer for no reason.
What's his name? Spencer Brown broke my arm. This kid named Will broke my arm. Spencer Brown broke my collarbone, actually. This kid named Will broke my arm. And I saw him later at a movie-making camp, actually.
Hmm. Small world.
Yeah. Teeny tiny.
Yeah. All right. Well, I guess we can move on.
Threw me off a log.
Threw you off a log?
Yeah. True story. Like, dang, didn't know you were that strong, pal.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay, so I guess we can move on to our retro review of...
Did you understand the significance of the squirrel falling out of the sky? He switched universes and fell out of the sky and, like... Did you?
No.
Okay, let's move on now. Like, the squirrels really... That really gets me, but
okay.
Let's keep going.
Yeah. Oh, then there's that whole romance with the old lady. The older lady.
So freaking stupid.
Yeah. To our retro review of The Nice Guys from 2016.
He's Clip of Ryan Gosling being charming.
Here's a clip.
Who is it?
Messenger service. Hollow March home?
What the fuck?
Mr. March, we gotta play a game.
I think you have the wrong house.
It's called Shut Up Unless You're Me.
I love that game.
You're a private investigator?
Look, there's $20 in there, all right? Just take it.
No, I'm not here for that. I told you. I'm a messenger. You can afford to live like this as a PI?
What's the message?
Oh, right. Stop looking for Amelia. Right?
I'm not even looking for Amelia. She's a person of interest, man. Fine. I'm done. Put a fork in me. Don't really put a fork in me.
Amelia's going to be very happy that you got the message so quickly. It's going to make her smile. That's good. Now, I got one more thing I need to ask you before we're done here.
You want to know who hired me?
Bingo. Yeah. So we can do this the easy way, we can do it the
Glenn.
Hard way. What?
Lily Glenn. Two N's. Old lady hired me to find her niece on Tuesday.
You just gave up your client.
I made a discretionary revelation.
No, you just gave her up. I asked her one simple question. You gave me all the information.
I thought that's what you wanted.
What?
All right, so like we said, The Nice Guys was released in 2016 and is written and directed by Shane Black, or co-written by Shane Black, and stars... King. Yeah, Russell...
A Knight of the Round Table.
Yeah, stars... Russell Crowe, Ryan Gosling. We'll get to that. Angouri Rice.
Little Australian. I guess she's not little anymore. Wait, can you click on her, see what else she's been in lately?
Sure.
Because I feel like she really should have skyrocketed.
She's going to be in the new Spider-Man, for
good
one thing.
For her.
Oh, and she was in the Homecoming. She was in...
Oh, she's killing it. Yeah, who did she play?
Betty.
Who the F is Betty? I guess if she's in both, then she's fine.
And she was in The Beguiled, the Sofia Coppola as well.
Yeah, I want to watch that, but also I don't.
You're not going to like it.
You feel me?
Yeah.
But it looks so good. But also,
I
know.
We can retro review it, right?
You know, the thing is, Henry, it looks good, but I know what I'm getting myself in for. Yeah,
if I didn't like it, I don't think you're going to. You know?
That's usually not how it works.
Well. and yeah, Matt Bomer.
Oh, yeah.
Keith David. Might be about it. And the
Bumblebee.
Yeah. And the synopsis is, in 1970s Los Angeles, a mismatched pair of private eyes investigate a missing girl and the mysterious death of a porn star.
Hmm.
So this one was not a huge hit commercially, but was
pretty
well received.
You know what was a huge hit commercially?
What's that?
Their press tour.
Why is that?
People just loved it. But it's really just Ryan Gosling is super charming with people that generally people think are grumpy. Like Russell Crowe. Like Ryan Gosling made Russell Crowe happy and no one had ever seen that. And like Harrison Ford.
Have you seen the, or have you listened to the Russell Crowe interview about Robin Hood where he walks out of the interview?
No.
Someone was questioning him about his accent and Robin Hood. And he got so angry that he just left.
Yeah, the interview. Sucks.
Yeah,
he seems like the worst.
Yeah.
Like the set of Superman must have sucked.
Oh, yeah.
Those origin scenes.
Oh, yeah.
Yikes. Uh-oh. The two most annoying men on the planet.
Yeah.
Who's the lady in that?
Diane Lane or Amy Adams?
No, the old lady is Diane Lane. Yeah. I don't like her either, so.
Yeah.
There we go.
Check her out in Serenity if you want to see some true acting.
Oh, my God. I forgot. Ugh, she's not good.
Yeah.
Lord.
So, yeah, this one, I love the movie, Chloe.
Instant classic.
Yeah. It's hilarious. It's.
Let me point out that I'm not so on my soapbox. I can't appreciate a movie just because it's a little like, it's not the most, it's not going to change the world socially, you know? I still think this is a really good, hilarious, entertaining movie, even though it's a little like, it's like when the old guy says something, you're like, oh, probably shouldn't say that, right? Like a little bit, not even that much, you know what I mean?
Sure.
It's a little problematic in some ways for me and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
That said, love it. This should highlight the fact that Under Silver Lake is offensive.
Sure. This one calls back to things, but in a more earnest.
And actually aware.
Less self-indulgent. Kind of way, right?
Yeah. It's dope.
Yeah. And the plot is at least...
It makes sense. Thank God. There's like a payoff. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like when you get to the end, you're like, okay.
Yeah.
You know? It was worth the crazy labyrinth of a time. You know what I mean? And I need that. Sorry. I need that.
Yeah.
I need the payoff.
Yeah. But it is... It does involve filmmaking, I guess you can say. But, I mean, it's about the porn industry. But there's still plenty of...
Lil nods.
Yeah, it's very, very well written.
I mean, he's the best.
Yeah, Shane Black is...
Come on.
I guess most recently he did The Predator, which, Chloe, you didn't see.
The best... Oh, my God. If you haven't seen it out there, anybody, Kiss Kiss Bang Bang is a classic.
Yeah.
That is, if you ask me, by far his best movie. Like, it's so... No? Disagree?
No, I like this more than Kiss Kiss
Bang Bang is so good.
I know.
Oh my God.
And he also wrote Tony Scott's The Last Boy Scout, which I like a lot.
That's not a biggie.
I know.
Did he do one of the Iron Man?
He wrote Iron Man, Iron Man 3, which is the best one, I would say.
I like that he can go all over the place as well.
Yeah.
Respect.
So I liked The Predator, even though it got kind of.
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, you use the right word. It's so earnest. Like, it's sweet. Like, it has that sweetness. It's not a sweet movie. Like, there's a lot of, I don't know about killing people necessarily. I don't love that just because it kind of messes with the tone a little bit, that kind of stuff. You know what I mean? Like, it's this sweet, but then there's like this random, like what? But like, not in a very intentional way. It just seems a little tone deaf. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, that's like a little nitpicky. That's like, a little nitpicky overall. And I think this one, like, you liked the, like, absurdity and the weird characters of Under Silver Lake and stuff. But, like, Matt Bomer in this, like, way more entertaining and interesting to me than, like, I'm a low-key but not in a good way obsessed with Homeless King. Like, that's so weird.
loved Homeless King.
Bizarro. But, like, Matt Bomer in this is, like, way more interesting. The movie just has, like, a lot of charm and I feel like it has more heart. And the other one is just, like...
I mean, this one is definitely much funnier and much more consistent in what it's trying to be.
Yeah.
Much more focused vision.
I love me a focused vision.
Hey, who don't, right?
Well.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Maybe David, but. Yeah, I think Ryan Gosling and Russell Crowe are great by themselves in this, but they're also a very good pair on screen as well.
So I think Ryan Gosling has just is the most charming person on the planet, maybe. Oh,
yeah. Most people think that, yeah.
Like, I didn't really realize it until I realized.
You're a late bloomer on Gosling.
Gos train. I think I was an early bloomer and then a late bloomer. Basically, like, everything you don't want to be.
Mm-hmm.
But he's just, yeah.
He's a great guy, it seems.
It seems so. I don't think he's, like, the best actor in the world. Like, I used to a lot more than that. Maybe he's, like, kind of settled.
See, I think he's gotten better.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Like, I prefer everything, like, post, like, Place Beyond the Pines and Blue Valentine.
You would.
Everything after that, I like more than I like things before that.
Not all the way, of course, back to Young Hercules, but you know, post Murder by Numbers, pre your area.
Have you seen the Believer?
Yeah, that's intense, yeah. Man.
It's been a while since I've seen that, but it's.
I mean, Lars and the Real Girl is.
I love Lars. That is true.
Is in like my top. I mean, beautiful.
Yeah.
His performance is so good.
Oh, yeah. It's good.
Rivals Leo's, y'all, in The Aviator. Wow.
That is on Amazon Prime if you haven't seen it.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
I'm going to have the... I don't know why I said it like that. I have the DVD. Sorry, Henry. I know I'm a pleb.
Jeez.
My DVDs.
Get with the times.
I know.
But, yeah, and I think for the most part, the girl is good. Maybe at times...
She's good.
She's a little over the top, but... Maybe it's more so the writing.
That's why the writing.
Where it's, yeah, exactly. It's where like she's that kind of almost like Wes Anderson like, and she's the adult. She's a kid, but she acts like an adult, whereas adults act like kids.
Yeah. Which, like, exactly. I think it comes down to the writing on that one. Like, yeah. So sorry.
No.
Not to delve in too much to like what we can relate to and whatever, right? But like, I feel like. Precocious girl should be written better. Like, there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I feel you there. We need some. We need that I Am Sam writer to come in here, have a little talk.
Yeah.
Then go away.
Yeah. But I do love
like Ask Jeeves.
Yeah. But yeah, I do love it. It looks great.
Looks
I think.
Dope.
And
this is some magical realism I can get behind.
Yeah, like the Richard Nixon.
Crazy
thing is great.
The third act is like insanity.
Yeah,
I'm not mad at it. I don't love it. Like you love it.
I don't love the third act, but
I just mean the movie.
Oh, you just said you love it.
You know how I am.
No, I do love.
You know, if I actually loved it, I would be out of this chair.
That's fair.
One way or another.
That's fair.
Come on.
If you were like,
don't say it.
Go
I'll
ahead.
Flip over.
Yeah, never.
Don't
mind.
Pick anything.
Yeah.
You insinuated you were going to say something I truly loved, and my body almost can't control itself. Like,
yeah,
I don't know what to do. I want to.
There's excited, and then there's Chloe excited, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, it's rare that ever comes out in its true form, but when it does, it's
when it does, it's crazy.
Yeah,
but like when Dave Franco popped up as the yarmulke wearer in If Beale Street Could Talk, I told you I. Fell out of my chair. I went bananas when that happened. And I'm not proud of it exactly, okay? But it's like if you guys watched Homecoming and you saw the dude who catched Beyonce, who caught, I'm so sorry to say catched, that's embarrassing, who caught Beyonce's towel. He is my, yeah, like that's my vibe.
Oh, yeah.
That's a mood.
Sorry, I had Spider-Man on my mind. Sorry. Because Homecoming,
we had that issue last week. Yeah.
But yeah, I love the scene where they go to the that house party where he like, you know, he rolls down the hill and he's that whole sequence is amazing.
It's quite interesting.
I love
the car scene by the party.
Yeah. Yeah. That's good
is
as
that
well.
What you're talking about? No.
Yeah. Yeah.
What I like. Well, I mean, does my thing connect to your thing?
Well, like where he's swimming with the mermaids and stuff like
That's pre my thing.
Okay.
They're both good scenes.
Like where the guy gets hit by the car?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's good.
I really like that scene.
Yeah.
But even though that's an example of like, we didn't quite need that, but all right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I there are parts of her character that kind of remind me of you, actually, where she's like the guy is dying, but she's like, oh yeah, he's like a murderer, but then you're like, oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I'm sorry you got slammed by
Thanks,
a car.
Henry, that was actually really sweet.
You're welcome. But yeah, it's and I guess with Shane Black, there's always a Christmas callback.
Always.
Which I guess is at the end, right? It's like the last scene is Christmas-esque. But yeah, it's just I don't hear many people talking about it.
It's
even.
A fun movie.
Yeah, but
you could watch this many a time.
It's a gem. It's a hidden gem.
It is. I agree. I do. Is it a masterpiece? Some might say.
Some may say that.
I wouldn't verbalize that. But I would definitely watch it several times on several occasions.
Mm-hmm.
It's an enjoyable movie.
Yeah.
Not top on my list. Certainly nowhere near the bottom, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's been a while since I've seen Kiss Kiss Bang Bang.
Oh, so
been a good. Few years.
100% his best.
Yeah.
It's also been a few years since I've seen it.
Yeah.
But.
Could this be a Fear and Loathing issue or situation?
I don't think so. I think it's like a known classic Kiss
Bang Bang. I think it'd hold up. But
yeah.
Yeah, it's check it out if you haven't seen it. Right?
Check it.
Yeah.
Double feature.
Yeah.
Yeah, this movie's quite funny.
Yeah. One of the few great comedies from the last couple of years. So
I don't know.
Right?
I guess.
There's not much.
Lady Bird's hilarious.
But is that that's not a first and foremost a comedy, I would say.
Neither is this.
It's funny, but I think this is
an action movie.
I think this is a comedy. No. This isn't an action movie.
There's a lot of action.
There is, but I don't think Shane Black set out to make an action movie. I think he made a comedy.
Well, all he makes are action movies.
I think he does both. I think in this case, it's a comedy that has action in it. I think that's what's great about it. It's many different genres. You can't place it, although it's a comedy. But
nailed it. Can't argue with that logic.
Yeah. So, all right, well, cool. A quick little review, but that's okay.
What else do we say about it? I don't know. It's weird. There's some weird stuff in there.
Give it a poke, yeah. Well,
ask first.
Yeah. Out of five? You say ask first?
Sorry. Sorry.
It's a five for me. It was one of my favorites of
2016.
I think in my top four or five.
Trois and a quarter.
All right. Cool. Well, I guess we can move on. Chloe, any news? You want to talk about that Sonic the Hedgehog trailer?
The kids are all talking about it.
Are they?
They're really excited. Yeah.
Have you watched it?
No.
It's...
I didn't know until yesterday when the kids were all talking about that it was a thing.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't... In the big scheme of things, it doesn't look great. It does look kind of fun. I will say this. And I think it's voiced by the guy who's John Ralphio. And I think.
Ben Schwartz?
I think. I could be wrong. It sounded
draw
like him.
Me in.
But Jim Carrey is in this.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, he's the villain.
He's back. Oh, yeah. He's such a good.
Yeah.
I don't know why he hasn't been utilized more as a villain.
Yeah.
Dang. But get him in a Bond movie, honestly.
Yeah. But
Rami Malek, move the F over. Let's get Jim Carrey as a villain. Wouldn't that be so sick?
That would be good.
He should be in a Batman. Can he be like the Riddler or something?
He was.
Was he the Riddler?
Yeah.
Oh my God, I'm so good. Well, which one?
Batman Batman Forever. It's not good. But.
Okay. Wow, I'm so A+.
That was weird. Chloe. Come on. That was weird.
Come on.
Weirdly,
I have great
on point.
Taste.
Yeah.
That's like, I watched the trailer for We've Always Lived in a Castle. Looks so bad. I would have done such a better job casting that.
Hmm.
We talked about it.
Okay.
I cast Bella Heathcote and Ella Purnell as the sisters instead of Alexandria
Daddario.
Daddario and like Tessa Farmiga, who I need to remind everyone because I'm shutting down right now when I think of it, that Tessa Farmiga is Vera Farmiga's sister, not daughter.
Yeah, that is
that
weird.
Has me shook to my core.
Very strange.
Big hate on that one. Crispin Glover plays the uncle. I think it should be Ethan Hawke. Sebastian Stan is the only one we can kind of deal with as the cousin. Shockingly, guess who I would pick, Henry?
Army?
He'd be so busy if I was in charge of the world. Gosh darn.
Yeah.
But yeah, Sebastian Stan we can kind of get away with, but no.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, so if I cast it, so watch out, y'all. If I cast it, that'd be dope.
I'm really starting to dig Sebastian Stan. I love him as... People seem to hate on him as the Winter Soldier, but I...
Because that stupid hair they gave him.
I love his hair. I think his hair rocks.
Well, that makes sense.
Yeah, that's fair. Yeah. Yeah. Well, can't argue.
You're punk that. Rock, Henry.
Thank you.
See, you took that as a compliment.
Yeah. I wish I could paint my nails, though, but...
Aww.
The job...
poor baby.
...prohibits me, so...
Wow.
Yeah.
Do they prohibit ladies?
No. They're not...
Do they not?
Oh, you mean ladies...
No, not their... ladies. Ladies paint their nails.
Oh, yeah, they do. It's everybody. Okay. Like you said, do they prohibit ladies from working there? No, they don't.
It's illegal, so it's good.
It's true.
Oh, my God, I was filling out this... I got this thing. Did I tell you? No, I didn't tell you. I got this thing. I got this thing. I'm being commissioned by the city for a public artwork. I'm very excited about it.
Wait, so...
Yeah, very exciting. Wait,
what's this going to be about? Like, what's this? Are you getting your art showcased somewhere?
No, I'm making a piece of art for the city.
Oh, wow. Where's it going to be?
This is the... this part does not sound very good.
Go for
it. Okay, so it's a mural, technically.
Okay, love them.
It is... I really know. This is about to go way downhill. It's not. My dad would be so mad at me for putting myself down. Apparently, it's a huge deal. I'm like the youngest person to be commissioned by the city for a... It is a bus stop.
Hey, nothing wrong with that. I love artwork at bus stops. That's cool, though.
It is the bus stop itself.
Think about how many people are going to be looking at that.
That's right.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
So my point was...
I've never had that, so I can't.
Oh, you never tried.
True.
Yeah.
True. Maybe we can get the podcast.
Cute. Yeah, that's what I'll do. I'll change my proposal and just make it our logo.
Great marketing.
I'll sneak the URL into my artwork.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let Andrew Garfield find it.
It's like
it.
In Under the Silver Lake. Yeah.
Stupid movie.
Yeah.
So anyway, but yeah. Oh. So on the thing. Ugh. Am I being too? No, I'm not. It's fine. I can do it. It's fine. Thank you for allowing me to be myself.
Do you know what it's going to be?
What?
The mural. What it's going to be?
Yeah.
What is it?
You'll see. But the point is, on the contract, it was like, check off these things. If you're a woman-owned business, a minority-owned business, or disabled-owned business. I said, oh, shoot. I'm on the trifecta here. I got all three, technically, right?
Wow.
However, in the details, it said, just to be clear, it didn't say it that sassily, but it said that. This is what we mean by minority. Guess what wasn't in there?
What's that?
0.01% of the population, y'all. Jews.
Wow.
Isn't that bad?
Yeah.
How are we not a minority? We're 0.01% of the population.
That does seem weird.
Not 0.1.
Point 0.01.
A one.
That's crazy.
And I marked it anyway. I said F this.
Mm-hmm. That's crazy.
Yeah. If you're going to ask, like, it's weird you ask, but if you're going to ask,
yeah,
you should, you know?
Well, either way, congratulations.
Thank you so much. I'm sorry. I don't remember why I brought that up.
No, it's okay.
Why'd I bring that up?
I don't know.
Shoot.
Chloe, can I say this? So now you have some artwork at the Antonia's restaurant, yeah. Right? As well as some other places, mm-hmm. I'm sure. Whenever I see one of your works, I immediately know it's yours.
Aw, thank you, Henry.
You have a style that I'm like, oh, that's cool.
That's so sweet.
That's
a big deal, actually.
Like when I was working at Antonia's, I didn't know that at the time you had work there. I said, oh, that's Chloe.
Aw, that's so nice. Thank you, Henry.
You're welcome. But all right, well, cool. Not much other news, Chloe. Anything?
Angelica Houston is canceled.
People are going apeshit for Game of Thrones. The final battle is too dark. Haven't seen it though, but although
we can't talk about it. I can't watch it because Connor's been too busy with finals, so we haven't seen it.
But can I say this?
Kaylee, Connor, and I have watched every single episode together.
Can I just say this? I love battles where I can't see anything. I love it. It's you know, King Arthur.
We'll see.
But
yeah, we'll see. Oh yeah, that's true. Yeah. I don't know. But
people are just up all over social media. Jeez, calm down.
I'm trying to think. Shoot, there was a lot of news, and I made a little note card. I left it in my car.
You can save it for next time.
What? There's nothing that good on it I would remember.
Oh, okay.
That's not true. We all know how my memory is. Swiss cheese.
Yeah.
But, you know, whatever.
I just got some Swiss cheese. It's really good.
I'm allergic to dairy.
I know.
I'm allergic to everything.
I know, Chloe. Yeah. I'm sorry. But, all right. Well, cool. I guess we can move on. So, to some listener mail. And so, the filmbudspodcast@gmail.com is the address that you can reach us at. Also, on Twitter at FilmBuds and on Instagram and on Facebook. So follow us if you haven't yet.
Wow.
Send us questions, comments, whatever.
Whatever you want.
Yeah, whatever.
Relationship.
I was about to say that. Thank you. Which
we want to have a new segment.
I feel like maybe once we've had that, maybe early on, but I can't
remember. No way.
Maybe. Listeners, go back and listen to the early episodes. See if we've had any relationship questions, but...
Ask us how to propose to your significant other. That's like, I'm so good at that.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
So please send us anything you like. And yes, so the one we have this week is from John Teeger in Nashville.
Ooh.
Yeah, very exotic.
Wow.
Says, hi, my buds.
Oh my God, I accidentally went to Tennessee. Is that where Nashville is?
Yeah.
Dope.
Cool. Sorry for the randomness of this question.
Never,
but
John.
Yeah, but since you do talk about favorite musicians and bands, I wondered what were both of your top five favorite albums of all time.
Oh, geez.
Love the podcast very, very much, and thanks for the bonus shows. Keep them coming.
Thank you, John.
Yeah, thank you.
Love you.
So, yeah, I told Chloe about this question just about an hour before we recorded.
Yeah, I forgot you told me.
Really?
I can wing it. I'm going to make some... parameters to make things easier for myself.
Yeah, I have five, and then I put some honorable mentions in there.
Of course you did.
Should I just go ahead and...
Yeah, go for it.
That way you can prepare.
All right, won't help.
Starting number five here, going down.
Oh, shoot. Like, they're supposed to be in order?
I don't know. I
need a paper and pen. Okay, go for it.
So number five. Now, there are a ton of ones that could be in the fifth one.
Oh,
I mean, it's like, it's kind of hard
snooze
to...
Snooze fest.
It's kind of hard to pick one.
Okay.
Why is that snooze fest?
Go ahead.
Okay, sorry. So number five is one I only kind of came across about maybe 2 years ago, but it's Odyssey and Oracle, the Zombies album.
I love the Zombies. Whoa. I would not have thought we would have. I didn't see this coming.
Hey, me neither. I was going through various things.
Zombies are so good.
Oh, that's right. I love that album.
Wow, I'm shook. They were here. Did you go see them? We should have gone together.
Oh, darn. Well.
Come on.
They'll probably be around forever, right? You know.
No, they're old AF.
I know. I was kidding.
Oh, well, they're zombies.
Oh, foul! Oh, good joke. Okay, took me a second, but number four, Glorious Results of a Misspent Youth, the Joan Jett album. I love. I think it's maybe her third or fourth.
My grandpa really liked Joan Jett.
Really, I'm seeing her in August.
I thought she was dead.
She's very much alive. No, but I'm seeing her.
I think she was dead.
I think she's like 60 now, but I'm seeing her in August.
She's definitely older than 60, I think. No. Was she at Woodstock?
Don't know.
Maybe my grandpa didn't like Joan Jett.
I mean, she was like 18 or 19 when The Runaways came out, and that was in the 80s, I think.
Who was at Woodstock? I don't know.
Hendrix?
My parents were at Woodstock. No, a lady. I think it was Joan Jett, no? I don't know.
Joan Baez?
No.
I don't know.
Oh, my God.
Janis Joplin?
Yeah, that one.
Yeah, I love Joan Jett, and I can't wait to see her in August. And then number three, it's kind of hard to choose one, but it's more so just the sum of their parts. But Help, the Beatles album. I could pick really any of them, but
no,
you know,
I only like their first three albums.
I think this is one of the first three.
I'm just saying, I only like their first three.
Hmm. And then number two, I was talking about it earlier, is Amy Winehouse's Back to Black.
Should I guess number one?
I don't know if you'd get it.
Ooh, I only know the name of one of their albums,
yeah,
so probably
you wouldn't get it then, yeah. And then number one is Green Day's 21st Century Breakdown.
Oh, shoot. Is that the one with the grenade?
No, that's American Idiot.
Oh. That's funny because that's the one I knew.
This one came out, I think, 5 years after American Idiot, and it was the first like one that really kind of made the impression on me. But I love it. I think it's their best one. And so that's, yeah, my number one. And then honorable mentions would be American Idiot on there. So Chloe, you were close. And then some others. There's plenty I'm forgetting. I just kind of made this relatively quickly, but Hunky Dory, the David Bowie album, I love.
Oh, I love
Bowie or that album.
Well, both.
This Is War, the 30 Seconds to Mars album, and you can check out the documentary about how they made it and the struggle to make that. But yeah, really very good album. Celebrity Skin, the album by Hole, Courtney Love's band from the 90s and the early 2000s. Very good album. A Night at the Opera, the Queen album featuring Bohemian Rhapsody.
You have so many.
I know. What can I say? I love music, Chloe.
I'm only doing 5.
Okay. Enema of the State, the Blink 182 album.
That's gross.
The classic album from, I guess it's 2000 or 1999, but it's kind of one of the defining punk albums from that era. And I think that's it. Yeah, that's and there's plenty of others, but I would take too long. Chloe?
Okay. I'm only doing new stuff.
That's fine.
Like, I'm not including Lou Reed or any of that.
Okay.
Because it'd make my head hurt. Okay. So, I didn't put them in order. Okay,
that's okay.
Well, my favorite album of all time.
Do you want me to say it?
Yeah.
Sam's Town.
Yeah.
By
Sam's
the Killers.
Town by the Killers is my number one album of all time. Shoot. What else do I got? All right. These are in no particular order.
Okay.
I also really like Day and Age. It's my other favorite Killers album.
Right. That's Gemma's favorite, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
A Brief Inquiry into Online Relationships is like my current one of my favorites. It's the new 1975 album.
Ah, okay.
It definitely won't last as like one of my favorites for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
But since it came out, that's where we at.
You're digging it.
Modern Vampires of the City by Vampire Weekend.
Okay. Is that one of their most recent? Or
yeah.
Is that one of their... Because, I mean, I know of them, but
I think it's 2 albums ago.
Okay. I like the one with the orange and white background, whatever that one is, that has, like, Holiday. And
yeah, it's not that one. That's the first.
I like that one.
Makes sense. And then, I'll do one honorable mention.
Okay.
Okay. Then Chanel Orange, Frank Ocean.
Okay.
And then the honorable mention, because this is cheating, is Cage the Elephant's album Unpeeled, which is basically just live versions of their like greatest hits.
Okay.
Like they did an album of their greatest hits basically.
All right.
And it's obviously it's solid. It's got their greatest hits.
Yeah.
So minus one of my favorite songs of theirs, which is it's not a guilty pleasure, I shouldn't say that. But I love it. It is called Around My Head.
Mm.
That's not on there, but basically all my other favorite songs are on there because I'm basic too.
Mm.
So.
One, speaking of a...
the suspense. Oh my gosh. I also really like Flamingo by Brand Flowers. But I'm not going into the old stuff because too much.
Speaking of Lady Bird, one of my favorite lines from that movie is, and in a way it's true, is like when... she's at college,
yeah.
And that guy's like, why do you all just have greatest hits album? And she says, because they're the greatest.
Yeah.
And then, I mean, in a way, it makes sense. And
I love that.
But yeah,
call
so.
It tight.
I mean, but yeah, I mean, there are plenty of others we could mention, but you know, time is tight, right? Time is tight.
Yeah, hella tight.
Yeah. So cool. Well, thank you so much for the email. Hopefully,
John.
That satisfies you.
His name John.
John.
Thanks,
yep, you got
John.
It. And if you have any favorites, send them our way.
Tell us, John.
If you have any that
John,
we would like,
a couple
or,
of your
or
faves.
Anybody, we'd love to check them out. So cool. Well, again, yeah, make sure to, and all the contact information is in the show notes as well as the bonus show link on Bandcamp. So check them out if you haven't. And
also, probably the Day and Night albums by Kid Cudi.
Okay. Haven't listened to that one.
Oh, also Coloring Book. Duh. Okay, go ahead. Oh, also the honorable mentions is the Carters.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. 704 is so good. Okay, go ahead.
I guess we can end off with our picks of the week, right? And so should I start? As usual. So I did mention earlier, I watched a new Amy Winehouse doc called Amy Winehouse Back to Black. And this one is solely about her making the titular album and has some unseen footage, new unseen footage. And it's just a really best thing about this movie, 58 minutes long.
Come on. Yeah. Can't beat it.
Yeah.
I thought, how you pissed at Guava Island for being...
Oh, no, well, that's the thing. Although I loved
it's
it.
A documentary. I didn't know it.
I didn't know that going in. It could have used another 20 minutes. But it's still a solid doc. Very interesting, introspective into someone like Amy Winehouse making her biggest album. And then also, it has a lot of
Scene with Amy Winehouse and Tony Bennett still haunts me. Like,
oh, yeah.
That was the saddest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah.
What a kind man.
Yeah.
God.
But yeah, and has some really interesting interviews with people who were more involved with like the music and the producing of it that wasn't featured in the Amy documentary by A24 that came out a couple years ago. But yeah, just a solid documentary, music documentary. If you like either Amy Winehouse or just the making of documentaries, check that one out. And then I also watched The Ninth Gate with Johnny Depp.
Yeah.
And this one is directed by Roman Polanski. I think it was one of his last films. And this one came out in the late 90s. And Johnny Depp is a kind of sleazy...
like Roman Polanski.
Yeah. Book dealer. And he...
not a combo you hear every day.
What's that?
Sleazy book dealer.
Yeah. And yeah, kind of a trickster, you know. And he ends up getting involved with some dark stuff dealing with the devil. And it's all about kind of unearthing books that might be written by the devil. And, you know,
I'd rather watch like Sabrina.
Oh, yeah, sure. Me too, in this case. But Johnny Depp is very good in the movie, but it really runs out of steam within like.
It sounds like a really cool idea. I wish Daniel Wallace wrote it as a book.
Yeah.
Which he low-key did.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Kinda. But it, like the first 30 minutes or so, I thought I was like, man, I'm going to love this thing.
Yeah.
But it really starts to drag and loses focus, much like how you would comment on Under the Silver Lake, you know. But yeah, not great, but Johnny Depp is.
30 seconds in.
Yeah, he's it's worth seeing just for that. And then, oh, I will mention music-wise, I don't know what gave me the urge to do this, but I listened to Lady Gaga's Art Pop. Have you listened to this album?
Yeah.
I think I was seeking out something of hers, maybe from A Star Is Born. I don't know. But I was like, I'll give this a listen. Why not? And it's, I mean, obviously, it's not my like type of music per se, but it kind of has this like self-aware kind of trashiness.
That's the idea.
Yeah. It kind of has this self-aware trashiness to it, which I kind of dug. I mean, Chloe, you know me. I like some good trash, you know, but
you love an airport novel.
Yeah. Well
it's
said.
It's a side of you. Yeah. It's a little sliver of you.
And
sure.
It's kind of has some cool techno vibes to it. And I thought it was a lot of fun actually. So it's not what I'm going to, you know, wouldn't be in my top 10 or anything, but I was pleasantly surprised. I was like, all right, I'm in. Cool art cover, artwork. I like that. Colorful, you know, all that jazz. But yeah, a little check out Art Pop if you haven't yet. If you like that kind of thing. But I think that's it.
I only have one thing.
Okay.
It's one of those where I tried to watch it. I was like, I don't like this. I'm so sad.
Okay.
I'm not a fan. Right? Then I was like, okay, I'll try again. And it's actually so good. Sex Education.
Oh, yeah.
On Netflix.
Haven't seen that yet.
You should watch it. You'd like it.
All right.
It's just sweet. It's like a Nick Hornby novel.
Yeah. Did you see that news piece about 13 Reasons Why? There's some study done about the suicide rate.
That's very confusing, though. I feel like there are so many variables works. It's not the word I was looking for, but
yeah.
Anyway.
So Cool.
That's nasty, though. I agree. You shouldn't make that stuff into a teen soap opera. It's ridiculous.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, cool. I guess that's... I thought I had maybe one other thing, but I won't mention... can't think of it. But, yeah, so cool. Well, I guess that about brings us to the end of the show.
That's that.
But, yeah, so again, next time we are going to, hopefully, if the guests follow through, we will do an Avengers in-game show. Better late than never, right? I mean, it's going to be in theaters for like a year.
True.
And so I think we have plenty of time to ride off of that hype train, right? And so, yeah, stay tuned for that. And again, don't forget to check out the bonus shows. Just donate a dollar. Why not? You know, it's like, you know, we talked about a bunch of different things. So it was... It was great. And so, yeah, well, Chloe, as always, it's a pleasure. Congrats about the...
Oh, thanks, pal.
And good luck with your other endeavors. You know what I'm saying here?
Oh, geez.
Little inside joke.
You'll have to pay more than a dollar to hear about that tea. Yeah. Thank you, Henry.
You're welcome.
Oh, but okay. Oh, my God. Okay. This is for off air.
Okay. But, yeah, so thank you so much for joining us. We hope you enjoyed it as much as we did.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll see you next time. Get on with it.